In this lecture, we're going to talk about the break and continue operators. And what they allow us to do is to define jumps in our code. And these are used inside loops, so we're going to talk about them now. So basically, the break operator allows us to jump to the end of a loop and just skip all further iterations, whereas the continue operator allows us to skip to the next iteration. So let's talk about the break operator first. Let's say we want to loop over each character in a string, something like Python, for example, and that we only want to print all the characters until the first O appears. So to do that, we could check if C equals O, and if that is the case, we're gonna break. And otherwise, we're just gonna go on normally and print our character. So let's first look at the result this gives us. Alright, so that's what we wanted to do. It prints the string only until the first O appears, which is this O right here. So what the break operator does is as soon as this is called, it's just gonna skip right here after the loop. So it doesn't just skip one iteration, but it actually stops the whole loop and jumps right after it. This is useful whenever we are only interested in the first occurrence of something. And inside our loop, as soon as we found that first occurrence, we can just break and go on after the loop. So in those situations, the break operator actually saves you time as well, because it skips unnecessary iterations. And that's why you would usually use the break. In this example right here, it's not just for performance purposes, but it actually helps us achieve what we want. But the more common case is that you just want to skip unnecessary iterations to save some computation time. Now let's move on to the continue statement. So in contrast to the break statement, the continue statement only skips one iteration and starts right with the next iteration inside our loop. So a common scenario where you would use the continue operator is where you have to loop over, let's say, a list of users, and you only want to work with users which are still active. So let's say you have a function that tells you whether the user object is active, and if not, you're just going to skip that user using the continue operator. So that way, you can avoid doing unnecessary calculations for inactive users. Now in this lecture, we're going to look at a more simple example. So I'm just going to create a list of strings with book, table, and laptop. So now let's try to loop over this array and only work with strings that actually contain the letter O. So to do that, we can use a for loop. And we're gonna say for string in list, open up curly braces. And now inside here, we can check if string contains the letter O. And actually, let's negate this condition. So we only want to work with strings that do contain O. So if they don't contain O, we're gonna say continue. And that's going to skip this iteration and move right on to the next element in our list. Now let's assume we would do some complicated calculations right here, which takes some time. Then we would actually increase performance quite a bit by skipping these unnecessary items and therefore skipping these calculations right here. But again, for this simple example, we're just going to print out the string to see what happens. So let's rerun this. And to make it more readable, I'm just going to include a print line, an empty one right here to just print another line in between. And now you can see that it still prints this path from up here. And also in this loop down here, it only prints those strings that contain the letter O. So it does not print the word table. All right, so that's how you use the break and continue operators. But I want to mention that you should use them sparingly. So there are legitimate cases to use them like these, but they can make your code quite confusing because, well, they include jumps, and jumps can become hard to follow for us. So you may run into bugs because of these jumps. So do use them if you really need them, but try to avoid them if it's not really necessary. Alright, so that's it for this lecture, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks so much for watching. If you've learned something new in this video, please make sure to give it a like. And also, if you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to be notified of any new tutorials. If you want to watch more, check over here, and I will see you in the next video.